Bonjour, mes amis. What I'm going to make for you next is a classic French dish, poulet sauté chasseur, or hunter's chicken. And let me explain to you what we're going to be putting in. 4-pound chicken, and this is a Butcher Boy product, best place for your meats and poultry if you're local. AP flour, now no fills, no fancies. Shallots, butter, French, tarragon, parsley, Noah's stock pots, that's where the flavors come from. Fantastic product. Portobello mushrooms, chopped, rough chop on it. This is a country rustic type of dish. Chopped tomatoes, and you could use your own if you want, but these are just canned tomatoes. A little bit of brandy, a little bit of white wine, salt, very little salt and pepper, olive oil. Okay.
And we get some broth over there too.
And yes, I'm sorry, last but not least, chicken broth. The chicken broth is this recipe calls for a dark broth. So to get it dark, what you got to do is use a 2-to-1 ratio. 1 cup of chicken broth to 1/2 cup of beef broth, and that's going to give you your dark recipe, or you could spend hours making your own stock, but not necessary. Okay, so what we're going to do with the chicken. Chicken is going to be breaded. It's an old type of classic thing that people don't do anymore. And the reason for the breading, one, it's going to give the crust on the skin on the chicken a very, very nice, dark, robust and coloring on it. And it's also going to help with thickening the sauce. The other thing, too, is you notice when I put the chicken in, you didn't get that classic sizzle because you really don't want that. And the reason being is that you want the chicken to cook slow. So we kind of want to sneak up on it. And that's the reason for that. So, as you can, we're getting a little bit of sizzle. The chicken itself, this is just an average 4-pound chicken. If you're gonna get something a little, if the chicken happens to be a little bit meatier and heavier, say in the 5 to 6 pound range, then what I would recommend you do, you could do it all in a pan, but you take a chance on burning it, and that's what you don't want to do, is preheat your oven, 350, and when you start this recipe, what you do is about 10 minutes into cooking, you transfer all the chicken to your sheet and pop it in the oven for 20 minutes. You don't want to completely cook it, but you want to make sure it's thoroughly cooked only on the bigger birds. And on this size piece of chicken, we really, really don't need that. So with that, we got the show going, and what I'm going to do next is we're going to get this thing nice and browned up, and why don't we come check back with me in a few more minutes, and I'll show you how the rest of it goes together. Welcome back, mes amis. Okay, chicken's been cooking approximately 10 minutes, 11 minutes. This whole meal, by the way, should only take about 20 minutes, not too much more than that, obviously depending on the weight of the bird. So, we're at the point, we're gonna start flipping the chicken and take a look at that. Golden brown, oh yeah. That's what you wanna see. That's what I'm talking about. So, we're right at the point where we're gonna flip these bad boys over and start to put the rest of the meal together. Okay, next into the party. It's French. We gotta put a little bit of butter in there. Depending on how much you want to use, that's up to you. It's French. It's gonna make it taste good. What the hell, you only live once, right? Let the butter melt down a little bit. Next thing in, we wanna use the shallots. I wanna get these going. Let the butter melt a little bit. And in go the shallots. Now, what you want to do is kind of make a hole in the center. You don't want them on top of the chicken because you don't want them to be rough. You want them to cook. And that's the way we're going to do that. So, luckily, they don't take long to cook. And let those work a little bit. And the next thing, start putting the rest of our ingredients in. So remember, this is French. There's no basil, no oregano. There's no anything else but that. We're gonna be getting in with tarragon, and there's no garlic. My brother-in-law, would Jim would be doing jumping jacks if he could. I know he could do one. He would be happy to hear no garlic, but there's no garlic in this recipe. So in a separate pan, I'm gonna bring up the heat. And what I wanna do is I wanna sweat out my mushrooms because you wanna get all the moisture out of those. So that's what that's happening there. We'll get those going. So that's first thing we wanna do. And oh man, I wish you could smell this right now. It smells awesome. Next, we're gonna add in our sauces. So we're gonna brandy the chicken. Now, when you're putting alcohol, well, no matter what it is, whether it's brandy or anything else, never put it directly on the chicken or whatever it is itself, because some of the residue of the alcohol goes on the meat and it never cooks. So we want to just put it around the side. And what that does by going on the sides of the pot, it's going to go underneath the chicken and cook from underneath it. And you can flambe it, but you don't really have to. It's unnecessary. And now we put in a little bit of white wine. Same principle. Go around the sides because we want to, in actuality, we want to cook off all the alcohol. I know. God forbid. Some of the people out there are having heart attacks right now. but it's for the flavor. It's the flavor. That's the name of the game. Mixed into the body is our chicken broth, beef broth stock. It's, you can, as you notice, it is a brown color. And that's because we are using a 2-to-1 ratio of chicken and beef. Beef being the one and chicken being two. So we're going to bring that up to a boil. When that comes to a boil, we're going to add in one of our magic ingredients, which is the Knorr's stock pot. The flavor, you got to start using this stuff, people. This is just really, really flavorful. I want to get my chicken back up to a boil right now. Mushrooms are doing good. I need to saute a little bit more. All right, once you get your stock pots open, just put those right in with the whole mixture. And what they'll do is they'll actually just dissolve right into the sauce. Right now we're waiting for that to come back up to the boil. And the next thing that's going to go in after the mushrooms start to make some progress here is I'm putting in the chopped tomatoes. And that's going in right now. And the chopped tomatoes, like I said, you could do your own if you want to go through the grief. And to do your own chopped tomatoes, basically bring a pot of boiling water to a boil. And you want a bowl with ice in it next to it. And what you do is you cut out the core of the tomato and you put a little X on top of it and you drop the tomato in. 20 seconds, 25 the most. And once you hit that 25 second mark, you take the tomato out, drop it into the ice cold water, and then take it out because it stops the cooking. And that will bring, the skin will peel right off, then you can chop it up and add it. But you can do the easy thing, like I said, this is an after work. You know, you don't want to spend hours and hours and hours cooking. And after work, you want to come home from work, you're tired, just want to get something done, boom, this is easy peasy. 20 minutes, 25 minutes, you get a beautiful meal, and it's a little bit out of the ordinary, you know? So, all right, things are starting to come to a boil here. We are going to put our tarragon into the chicken. And the tarragon, you can use it, I would say, you know, it has a very, very nice flavor. So you can use a decent amount. But if you make it, try using maybe like 2 tablespoons, maybe a little bit more, and then go from there and adjust. adjust your quantities from that. So we're gonna just let you take a 5-minute break because you don't want to look at things boiling, and come back and I'll show you how it all ends. Everybody. All right, chicken is all cooked, and you should do it, you know, your digital thermometer, check your chicken temp, should be 165, and that's where we're at right now. All right, my tomato and mushroom and parsley has already been mixed together, and I'm going to be adding this into the recipe, and this is going to be the final step in the whole process. Like I said, we really want to get as much water out of this as we can. We don't want to be adding more water to it, and that's why you cook that down. You could put it all in the same thing and just it would take a little bit longer, but we're just about there, and you'll get a final how do you do here in about 2 seconds. And that's pretty much all there is to le poulet sauté chasse on this chicken. And it's a very, as you can see, 25 minutes thereabouts, and very simple and a little bit out of the ordinary. So if you want to just take regular chicken and make it fancy for one night, I mean, 25 minutes, you get home from work, not a big deal. Preparation on this was less than 10 minutes, and that was cutting up a whole roaster. In a future video, I guess we could show how they teach in culinary school how you dissect the whole roaster, whether you want bone in or not bone in, and take it from there. So, voila, and enjoy. And oh yeah, by the way, go Bruins.